Better inside. A bit dizzy. It's gone now. All right, thanks.
I saw Joey with her once, I think.
Did you know she was married?
Maybe it wasn't her.
Joey never said nothing.
No, you know Joey. She don't want you to know.
How long's it been going on?
Griff reckons 6 months.
Well, what did Griff say?
What?
What did Griff say?
Not a lot.
Oh, Vin!
He wasn't exactly sober. None of us was. Says she was a bit neurotic.
Oh, yeah, of course. It had to be all her fault, wouldn't it?
I didn't say that he said anything about that.
Look, it looks as though Joey doesn't come out of this too good. I worry about Joey sometimes, you know. He's like a great soft kid. He's never grown up.
Maybe that's what turns him on, eh?
Joey hurts people, Vinny. He doesn't mean to, but he hurts people. Billy. What about Billy? Does Billy know?
We didn't want to muck up the party. It was going down the street.
Someone will have to tell him.
Joey had a word with Connie.
Oh, he'll go spare.
That's why we didn't say nothing last night.
Stinks. I didn't want to spoil your party.
That was thoughtful.
You know what I mean. I called the hospital. She's all right.
She's all right?
Yeah.
Belly full of pills, stomach pump, all the usual indignities. She's in hospital feeling like death warmed up, and here you are rotting in your family! Shirt over it, can you?
Hold up, Pop.
Ain't there enough little sweeties around?
You don't understand.
What is there to understand? You had your feet under some poor bastard's table. That ain't right, Joey, you know that. You're gonna bunny your way out of this. Who is he? Your old man.
Works away, he's never home.
That's convenient. What's his name?
Ronnie.
Married name.
Boyd.
Local.
You'd have heard about it if she was.
What are you going to do about it, Joey?
What can I do about it?
First off, you go and see her, you take her some flowers. Be nice to her, talk to her.
She don't listen, Pop. I've been trying to let her down gentle for the last month. Ask Griff here, tell you. She keeps ringing on and bloody on. That's why this place is like it is. I stay out. I kept in a cab a couple of nights. She's been putting the hand on people. They must think I'm a right rectum. All right. When I first pulled her, I knew she was married, but I mean, there was no cross legs or nothing. I mean, she's been around. I ain't the first. That's a million.
Joey. You ain't a kid no more. Ain't no good you turning around and saying that, blaming her. You start messing with married women, you're banging trouble, boy. Why don't you say something? To me, Con, Vinny, anyone.
I told Griff, didn't I?
Griff's not family.
It was my problem.
You know better than that.
Look, she bloody stabbed me, Pop.
Stabbing? Suicide? Why do you let things get this far? Why don't you come to me quietly? We could have worked something out together between us. None of this bloody madness need have happened. What's that?
Nothing.
Well, I heard something.
No, well, it's probably next door's cat gets in sometime. It's nothing there, Pop.
Sorry, Joey. I dropped my shoe.
You wicked little bastard.
So where do you want me to drop you off then?
Anywhere near Cadogan Square.
Oh, Cadogan Square, eh? Mm. I like a bit of rough around here, don't
I? Of course, you are speaking from experience.
Oh, not many. I had this little blonde sort about 2 years ago. Old man was a top brief, you know? She was divorced. Lived in this big house off Holland Park Avenue, it was. All right little handful she was.
And what happened?
Well, one night, she started to come on really strong, you know, so I gave her a smack. No, listen, she loved it. Kinky for it, she was. Ended up with a South African who was really into all that. Mind you, we did have £500,000 to go with him. Listen, why don't you bring her around the club tonight?
I only met her yesterday.
Well, I'll behave myself, you know, talk proper like, no, mate.
Leave off, right?
Well, first impressions are very important, Philip. How many times I got to tell you?
Well, just make sure she ain't married, all right?
Yeah. Well, Joey.
Yeah, but Billy's getting the right coke, you know. Okay, maybe see you at the club later on, then, eh?
Right, maybe.
Yeah, sell him.
Is Anna in?
No.
Ah.
Was she expecting you?
We didn't say it, Tom.
Anna didn't mention she was expecting anyone.
Will she be long?
I'm sorry, I have really no idea.
We were going out.
I'm Anna's mother.
Phil.
Philip. I thought I knew most of Anna's acquaintances in London.
At the university?
Forgive me, but you seem rather old to be an undergraduate.
I'm a mature student. Second year. Moral philosophy.
Do you know Anthony?
Anthony? Anna's fella?
They're practically engaged. Phil.
Not really.
No. Hello, darling. I did offer Philip some coffee, but he didn't want any.
Seem as close as fingers. Do you feel the space between us, where words like cigarette smoke hang around? Not quite strangers, not quite friends. Is it lonely where you are? I suppose you'd smile that woman's smile and say it just depends on what I mean. Are you just another cover of just another book to read?
Did she offer you coffee? She didn't, did she?
I really can't remember.
Don't, Phil, please. I have quite enough lies from my family.
Is it important?
She's not always been like that. She's been going through a difficult time.
Why search for water by a river? Sometimes answers don't need questions, and reasons can be lost before they're found. Like photographs of sad weekends. If I asked you who you are, would you turn and try to touch my hand and say it just depends on what I mean? Are we just another couple on just another city street?
My father's older, quite a bit older. It's funny, I never really think of him as ever having been young. He was married before, but she died. I have a stepbrother, Michael. He's one of those people who has an opinion about everything. He talks a lot, but he never listens.
We could pack our empty pockets with the memories we've borrowed from the people that left behind. Not quite strangers, not quite friends. Perhaps it's gone too far. Will you want to love and walk away and say it just depends on what I mean? Is this just another just another final scene?
Your mother said you were practically engaged.
Poor Anthony.
You make him sound like a victim.
Anthony is a victim, by vocation.
So?
We have what you might call an eroding relationship. My parents have made sure of that.
They don't approve.
Much more subtle than that. They make a show of their approval.
Hello, Terry.
Ray.
Look like you could do with a drop of medicine. What's up?
I'm punting a favour, Ray. I can't sort something out. I'm going to be up on one.
You've been working?
Yeah, and I dropped the bollock.
What happened?
I don't know. I dropped it somewhere. It was round this morning looking to give me a little tug. My junior got word to me.
Well, what they got on it?
You tell me. Thought it got off as sweet as a nut. Good little learner.
Well, maybe they were just being busy, you know, giving you a pull on your form.
Junior says he was trying.
Anyone we know?
DS called off.
No, never.
He said he was a pushy bleeder.
Aren't they all?
I don't know, I can't work it out, Ray.
It's a bit of work. Someone offered it up.
Bob Leonardi.
Well, he's pretty reliable, isn't he?
Well, I give him a tour. He was well pleased. You know me, Ray, I always work alone. They're careful.
Well, maybe somebody saw you.
Nah, too dark.
So what'd I say to Jeannie, then?
Just give her a load of fanny.
Go over the house.
I wish they had, they'd still be looking.
But they had a warrant, yeah?
Yeah, why?
A bit smelly. Seems like they already knew that you knocked it out. Who'd you place it with, Lakey?
Yeah. Yeah, that little dog's gone the other way, he's gonna get hurt.
So what's the favour then, Tom?
Well, I was here, wasn't I? At night.
What night was that then?
Week last Thursday.
Got a feeling you was now, come to think of it.
I wouldn't number you, Ray, but My genie, bless her heart, couldn't think of anything else on the spot.
No, that's all right. You better get lost, you.
We'll give you a tinkle a little later on, like, yeah?
OK. Don't worry, Till. We'll sort this one out, one way or another.
Ray, you're a diamond. There's a nice little drink in it for you.
She signed herself out.
When?
Early this morning.
She was only admitted last night.
Are you Mr. Boy?
Couldn't you stop her?
She wouldn't listen. Are you her husband?
Do you know where she's gone to?
She said her sister's. Mr. Boyd! Mr. Boyd, just a minute!
I said 12 o'clock is going on too.
Wait.
Oh, sorry, pal. I was expecting a piano player.
It's a nice place.
Yeah, it's a living. What are you doing, working or sightseeing?
You get a few faces in, do you?
Yeah, one or two now and again.
What about Terry Connell?
Yeah, he likes a quiet drink.
When did you see him last?
Terry? Oh.
I mean, recent?
No, not recent. About a week ago.
I call that recent.
Well, it depends what you call recent, doesn't it? I thought you meant last night. I wasn't here last night. It was at my old man's birthday party, wasn't it?
Wait. Are you trying to be smart?
No, just trying to be helpful. Do you want a drink?
No, I don't.
Oh. Suit yourself. Sunday, Monday. Must have been last Thursday.
Last Thursday, Terry Connell was doing a climb on a house in Hampstead. Could you hear me?
You sure you don't want a drink?
He's marked your card. Or his missus has.
Jeannie? Do you know I haven't seen Jeannie for months? I couldn't even tell you the colour of her hair.
You're a bastard liar. You know what I mean.
I don't, it's a fact.
He's in the frame.
Listen, whoever stuck him up is pulling your chain. If I was you, I'd have a little word with the dirty slag.
You listen to me. I'm going to nick Connell, and I'm going to give him some.
Cheers, pal.
Come on. And they said you was a bit of a tear-ass. You're just another mouth.
Anna! It's little what? Anna! Darling.
Oh, hello. Hello, Simon. I thought you were in Brazil.
Argentina, darling.
Look, we're rather late.
Come and have a drink.
I think you've had a skinful, pal.
I'm talking to Anna, pal.
Let me go, Simon.
You used to be such a friendly little thing.
You were embarrassing a lady.
Didn't you, eh?
I told you, you're embarrassing a lady.
You.
How do you like being embarrassed?
You bastard.
Don't start anything you can't finish, eh? Now then, you stay down there till we've gone, or you're going to get a lot more than a hangover.
Ah, so you made it then?
Yeah.
Ray Fox, big fan of yours. We used to watch you a lot of runnies.
Oh, you mean my pink period?
Listen, I'll give you this gig. You're going to smell a lot of booze. Reckon you can handle that?
I can try.
How long have you been dry?
18 weeks and 4 days.
Well, I want you here at 9 on a dot through till 3.
Sounds fair.
Where'd you live?
Tooting.
Drive?
I got my license framed in the Black Museum, haven't I?
Yeah. We'll make your own way here. Get a cab back on the house.
Nice one.
Start you off 25 a night, see how it goes. Meal if you want it. First time you turn up pissed, you're out.
You're on.
What about starting tonight, then?
Don't you want an audition?
Listen, if you're half as good as you used to be, still be twice as good as anyone else. Paid enough dough for it.
Arch finger for bark, flat fingers for love.
Art Tatum, right?
You know your jazz.
Should do. Old fella's a connoisseur.
She's left the hospital?
Yeah, early. She signed herself out. The sister said she was coming to you.
She's not here. Silly cow. Have you been round her place?
Well, no, I came straight here. She would have rung, wouldn't she, if she'd have been at home?
Her phone's been cut off. Oh, you's next door. She might be there. Hang on to her. Josie, can I use your phone?
Help yourself.
This is Joey.
I'll take her.
Yeah.
That's too much.
Go, go, take.
Be there, Liz. Please be there. You've got to find her, Joey.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, what's on your mind, Billy?
Do I have to have a reason to come and see an old pal?
You don't have to, but you usually do.
Since you ask. What do you know about a local lad called Ronnie Boyd?
Well, he's trouble. That's what I know.
Tell me about him.
What do you want to know for?
Is she a villain?
No, but he's a handful. I seen him on the Malice. He took on 5 spades. In a drinker, Streatham. He done 3 of them. The other 2 turned white.
Sounds useful.
Yeah. He ain't local. He's our boy. Moved down about 7 years ago when he married a local girl. He don't get around much. Works on the rigs. Diver. Underwater welder. What's the bother, Billy?
No bother.
Yet.
What's his missus like?
Oh, I don't know much about her. She's younger than he is. A good look at her if you like that sort. Word is that she puts it about a bit when he's away. This got anything to do with your Joey?
What makes you ask that?
Well, you know Joey. Put his leg across anything that moves. I've seen him around here once or twice recent night. And I thought to myself, you're well out of your manner. If he's been given her one, and Ronnie's found out, I'd get him insured.
Not today, Ray. Don't you ever knock. How's your luck?
Better up till now. What's up?
I hear you've been giving one of my team a vexing time.
Oh, Mr. Health and Strength, he one of yours?
Correct.
Well, he's a very pushy fella.
He's very ambitious.
You know, if he carries on like that, he's going to make himself very unpopular.
Nice little taste.
Shopping?
What you got?
Depends.
Click, click, click.
Depends
click.
What you got, innit?
I've got Terry Connell. By the plums.
Very painful.
Now, you know me, Ray. I'm a very amiable man, very accommodating.
And expensive.
Oh, that depends how you look at it. It depends, my friend, on how far the shit's up your neck. I mean, what premium does one put on one's liberty?
You know, you do have a sparkling turn of phrase, Alex.
Education, my son, a wonderful thing.
How much?
Got a lot of overheads. I mean, managing this place, you no doubt are well conversant with overheads.
How much?
Two and a half.
You must be joking. Listen, for that kind of money, Terry will take his chances.
He doesn't have any chances. I hope you impressed that on him.
Someone bubbled him.
Nothing so delicate.
No?
Is that what he thinks?
That's what I think.
$2,000. Last offer.
I'll have a word with him.
You do that. I'll call by tonight.
Not too early, eh?
You know me, Mr. Fox. Like your good self. A creature of the night.
You should be in bed.
I'm
I've been looking for you all morning.
It's a bit late.
Hey?
I was looking for you for weeks.
I never realised. I didn't think.
Well, you never do, do you, Joey? I mean, think about anyone but Joey. You're just like a spoilt little boy who's always got to be first.
Come back and sit down, eh?
Just leave me alone, Joey.
You've done in this. Look, I want to help.
Don't you think you've helped me enough?
I can't leave you like this. I've got the cab. Let me take you home.
Home? Where's that?
Well, your place.
Oh, I'd love that.
Who?
Romy! The police radioed the rig last night. The company flew in by helicopter to the mainland. The sister told me 5 o'clock this morning. And why do you think I got out of there? That'll be the first place you go.
He don't know about us.
Well, he may be a lot of things, but he's not a bloody fool. You don't think you're the first, do you? Oh, dear. Poor Joey. It's always got to be first.
What happened the last time?
He busted my arm and knocked 3 teeth out.
You never said nothing.
Oh, there's a lot of things I haven't told you about good old Ronnie.
Well, let me take you to Pat's then.
That's the second place he'll go.
Well, what are you going to do? You got to go somewhere.
I don't know. What do you care anyway?
Well, look, if I didn't care, I wouldn't be here, would I? Look, you got to go somewhere. Get things sorted out. Get some rest. Get something to eat. Let me take you to Vinnie's. You'll be safe there. Renee will look after you. She's a darling. Look. How far do you think you're going to get? If you collapse again, you'll go straight to hospital, and the first person they'll contact will be good old Ronnie.
Ronnie! She's not here.
Where is she?
I don't know.
She wasn't at home. I've been to the hospital. They said she was here.
Well, how did you know that she was...
Police radioed the rig last night.
Well, she was just depressed, Ronnie, that's all. You being away so much. Well, you know how she is. She's not been well. You know how things get on top of her.
What's been going off, Pat?
Nothing.
You're a bigger liar than she is.
Ronnie, don't!
I warned her last time, didn't I? If it happened again, I'd kill her.
Nothing's happened like that.
What, no other men?
There's been no one.
Are you sure?
Ronnie, I swear it.
Well, who was that at the hospital? The pretty boy with all the chat and the flowers. A bloody social worker! They thought he was me.
I don't know.
Yes, you do. She tells you everything, every dirty little detail. Turns you on, doesn't it? It's a big giggle to you, ain't it? Poor old Ronnie's stuck in the middle of nowhere, working his guts out. You must think I'm a pillock. Well, let's spend some more of his money.
You're wrong, Ronnie.
No,
you've got
sluts.
It all wrong.
Who is it, Pat?
You're mad.
Who is he?
You hit me and I'll go to the police.
You wouldn't, oh.
I would, and enjoy it.
You flim.
Lay one finger on me.
I'll find out who he is. And when I do, I'll push his face in a wall.
Shut up!
Nigerian lager.
You didn't want ice, did you, George?
No, just water.
That rusts your plumbing, George.
Cheers.
Can I have a taste, Frank?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, I don't know how you can.
It's good, that, mate. Real stuff. Better than that white rubbish.
You've got to watch your intake. You know what that stuff does to sailors?
Puts a spring in her own pipe.
Hey, George, fancy the dog's later.
I'm going to be tied up.
Can you smell something?
You trod on a frog, Willie.
Ah, must be the drains.
What do you want?
A quiet word, Mr. Mason.
What?
Can't hear you.
Can I see you a minute?
I'm busy.
It's important, Mr. Mason.
What is it?
Be shy. Right, Skeggy?
Skeggy? I want you a red coat from Skeggy.
Yeah, he had a glass eye.
He never did. He was a ventriloquist.
This better be good.
There's a face looking for someone.
Ain't there always?
Wants him bad. Been asking around.
So?
This someone's been messing about with his wife while he's been away. I know for a fact that someone he's looking for is Joey Fox.
Is it now? Fancy that. Jungle Joey.
I thought you'd like to know, Mr. Mason.
What's this face like?
Frightening.
This face got a name?
Ronnie Boyd. Do you know him, Mr. Mason?
Of him, Skeggy. Of him. Where's this face now?
Round the corner, in the tunnels.
Large malt, large navy rum, lad. What's yours, mate?
You talking to me? What are you drinking? You're, Ronnie Boyd.
Same again for him, lad.
Who are you two monkeys?
Easy, son. We've come to do you a favour.
258, please.
Here you're looking for someone.
Is that any business of yours?
What's that?
We've come to give him to you. Listen, Smiler, I'm not in the mood for any wind-up. Oh, dear, you are bending the wardrobe. Who is he? Joey Fox.
Forget.
Hold on. Go and change. I'll get myself a drink.
Well, there's someone in there.
Who?
A friend. From university. This is Philip Fox. This is my father, Phil.
Hello. Good evening.
There seems to be a bit of a mix-up.
Oh. But you've already eaten.
We were watching a film.
I was expected at a family friend's for dinner.
Ah, and you still are.
I forgot completely.
Anna only forgets when it's convenient for her to do so.
That's not true. You know that's not true.
Well, you might have had the courtesy to give me a ring.
I told you. I forgot about it completely. Look, I'm sorry. Sorry, sorry, sorry. I mean, how many times do I have to apologize?
And what do I say to them?
Tell them I'm not well.
Lie to them.
I'd better be going anyway.
Why?
Oh, I've got a few things to sort out.
I'm not going, Phil.
Look, can I beg a lift tomorrow?
You're going to be late.
Well, if Mr. Fox has to leave.
He's just trying to be tactful. Please stay, Phil. apologize for me.
I will not.
Please, Daddy.
Now, your mother will be very upset.
She didn't want to go.
What do you mean? What do you mean?
Nothing.
Then why did you say it?
Well, they're your friends, not really hers.
Why do you say such things?
I'm sorry.
And in front of a total stranger.
I'm sorry. It's always like that. I want to go to bed.
$2,000?
Well, I knocked him down from 2.5.
Greedy bastard.
Well, how much did you pull off that little job?
3.5.
I thought you told... What?
3.5.
I thought you told me it was a good little earner.
Well, you have to say that, don't you?
You risk 5 years for 3.5 grand. You want your head tapping.
Like most of the time was bloody petticoat lame, wasn't it?
Yeah, but that's not what's on the insurance claim.
Yeah, they're probably claiming 20 grand the bounce. It's worse than us.
Well, it don't make no difference, Terry. He wants two, otherwise you're for a walk up the steps.
Did he say how he won?
What? That slippery bastard?
It'll take a couple of days to get it together.
Look, take my advice, right? Why don't you just take it easy for a while?
Well, after this, I'll be on the black and I've got
look,
to
look, use your head. Stay out of his face, right? Work up north anyway, but down here.
Yeah, you're right, mate. Thanks anyway.
Well, listen, don't go home until I give you the word, eh? Just in case.
You later, Alex.
Alone.
He has to be in bed early. It's a growing boy.
You're jumping the red light a bit, aren't you, Alex?
I want you two to be pals. Well?
Terry ain't happy.
Show me a drowning man who is.
It's gonna take him a couple of days to get it together.
Make it Tuesday.
Where?
I'll let you know.
So we can go home then?
Well, that's where a married man should be. With his family.
Two brandy, Snoopy.
Yes, Governor.
See, I told you. He's a gentleman. Be lucky.
That'll be 50.
50?
Two brandies, pony each. Over it.
I would ram this up your nose.
Cheers.
Oh dear, you've got him cross again.
You're not giving him money.
Shut it. I do like your new piano player, right? Nice touch. Delicate hands. You're pushing it somehow.
What is he?
I should hate you to find out the hard way. Tuesday. Play Temptation.
Where is she? Where's the whore?
Oh, I'm gonna bruise you, pretty boy!
Where is she? She's gone! I'll find her! I found you!
Put it down, Ronnie.
Who are you?
Family.
Well, come on. I'll have the lot of you. Come on, come on.
No, you won't.
Well, come and try me, old man.
I'll bust your head open. And if I don't get you, you will. I ain't making excuses for him, son. He's a dirty little slag. He done wrong and he knows it. It takes two. Your missus. Ain't the first time, is it? Is it?
I warned her.
I know. Her sister explained to me.
That slag.
That's how he asked for this. And I feel the same. But there's an end to it.
I want him.
You take one fox and you take us all. I told you, we're family.
I'll find her. It weren't her fault. I'll find her.
Thank you.
love. Come from the hospital. You're supposed to be out here. Wouldn't you be better inside?
Bit dizzy. It's gone now. All right, thanks.
I saw Joey with her once, I think.
Did you know she was married?
Maybe it wasn't her.
Joey never said nothing.
Oh, you know Joey. He don't want you to know.
How long's it been going on?
Griff reckons 6 months.
Well, what did Griff say?
What?
What did Griff say?
Not a lot.
Oh, Vin!
He wasn't exactly sober. None of us was. Sis was a bit neurotic.
Oh, yeah, of course. And that'd be all her fault, wouldn't it?
I didn't say that he said anything about that.
Look, it looks as though Joey doesn't come out of this too good. I worry about Joey sometimes, you know. He's like a great soft kid. He's never grown up.
Maybe that's what turns him on, eh?
Joey hurts people, Vinny. He doesn't mean to, but he hurts people. Billy. What about Billy? Does Billy know?
We didn't want to muck up the party. It was going down the street.
Someone'll have to tell him.
Joey had a word with Connie.
Oh, he'll go spare.
That's why we didn't say nothing last night.
Stinks. I didn't want to spoil your party.
That was thoughtful.
You know what I mean. I called the hospital. She's all right.
She's all right?
Yeah.
Belly full of pills, stomach pump, all the usual indignities. She's in hospital feeling like death warmed up, and here you are rotting in your feathers! Shirt over it, can you?
Hold up, Pop.
Ain't there enough little sweeties around?
You don't understand.
What is there to understand? You had your feet under some poor bastard's table. That ain't right, Joey, you know that. You're gonna bunny your way out of this. Who is he? You're an old man.
Works away, he's never home.
That's convenient. What's his name?
Ronnie.
Married name.
Boyd.
Local.
You'd have heard about it if she was.
What are you going to do about it, Joey?
What can I do about it?
First off, you go and see her, you take her some flowers. Be nice to her, talk to her.
She don't listen, Pop. I've been trying to let her down gentle for the last month. Ask Griff here, tell you. She keeps ringing on and bloody on. That's why this place is like it is. I stay out. I kept in a cab a couple of nights. She's been putting the hand on people. They must think I'm a right rectum. All right. When I first pulled her, I knew she was married. But I mean, there was no cross legs or nothing. I mean, she's been around. I ain't the first. That's a million.
Joey. You ain't a kid no more. Ain't no good you're turning around and saying that. Blaming her. You start messing with married women, you're bang in trouble, boy. Why don't you say something? To me, Con, Vinny, anyone.